HP 14-inch touch Chromebook Intel Celeron 32 gigabyte with software. This is a Chromebook, you guys. It's the QVC's first Chromebook QVC 2, big deal. It's so cool because what you're getting is the design of a laptop, but the specs of a tablet with portability. So you get convenience, you get the benefits of a laptop, but you get the affordability and price of a touchscreen tablet. And it's all coming to you at 6 easy payments of $66.66. Brand new today. We also have special financing of 9 months on this and free shipping and handling. Coming to you from Hewlett Packard, which is a leader in the industry, bringing you state-of-the-art computers and totally loaded with benefits. So you seem to get it all here. I'm excited to hear about it. We have two color choices, the snow white or the chalkboard gray. So you'll get the notebook, the AC adapter, the premium service suite 2 voucher, and so much more. This does carry a dual core processor, 14-inch diagonal backlit touchscreen, HD touchscreen with it. It has 32 gigabytes of internal storage. It has 4 gigabytes of SD RAM with it. It also has Bluetooth wireless technology, HD graphics 500, dual speakers with it, HD webcam, dual array digital microphones, the full-size island-style keyboard with it, and the touchpad with multi-gesture support. Also, two USB-C ports, two USB 3.1 ports, headphone and microphone jack too. It measures 13.25 inches wide, 9 inches deep, and 3.25 inches high. Alex, I always get so excited when you're here. Thank you
great
so
to
much
see you.
For bringing this to me.
Of course.
So here's the thing. I'm a little bit confused because, like, is it a laptop? Is it an iPad? And what is Chromebook?
Oh, I'm going to tell you all about it. I'm so excited.
Okay.
And Antonella and I met a couple minutes before we went on air. And I said, Antonella, I am so excited that we're working together because just when I thought we had taught you everything you need to know about computers, we're going to kind of switch it up on you a little bit.
Oh, nice.
But I promise it's going to be easy. And that's why I'm so excited about Chromebook, because Chromebooks, it's really about simplicity. It's about what you do every day. It's about making your life nice and easy, less complicated.
Okay.
So you talked about it. It's got the functionality of a tablet, right? Because it is touchscreen, so I could use the trackpad if I wanted to, which, by the way, it's got a trackpad, so you can use that computer style like a laptop, right? But if you wanted to as well, you can just very simply go and touch the screen and make things happen as well. So you've got that type of tablet or smartphone experience. And I'm going to show you everything that you can do with Chrome, because again, Chrome is so simple that anybody can really pick it up and start using.
Okay.
So why don't we start from kind of the beginning, right? What do you like to do on your computer? What is it that you use your computer for?
Okay, I do emails. I like to kind of surf and shop.
Mm-hmm.
I like to maybe send text messages or pictures or what. I mean, I just do the basic stuff. But I want it done, and I want it done fast and quickly and efficiently.
Well, that's what you get with the Chromebook. The Chromebook is fantastic for that. We mentioned it's ultra portable. We're going to go through all the specs here so you know exactly how this is. This has an Intel processor, which we're going to talk about here shortly. So that's something that you don't necessarily get with the tablet. You've got Intel, the name that you know and trust. That's the processor or the brain or the engine, I like to say, behind your computer. So you've got that into your computer. You've got the ability to browse the web, to shop. But here's what I love about Chromebook. You have access to millions of apps from the Play Store. So if you have an Android phone, and I'm gonna show you right now because you're gonna see there's a lot of similarities. So I have an Android phone here, and what I'm gonna do is I'm going to show you, this is probably what you're accustomed to seeing, right? You're accustomed to seeing all of your apps here, and you know, you just very simply download an app and then you have it, right? Well, take a look at the Chromebook. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna touch right over here, the Google Play Store. My Play Store is gonna open up. It's the same type of experience that you've got on your smartphone. So if I want an app, I just touch it and it's gonna give me the ability to download and install, and then I have it on my computer, and then look, this is where it's all located. Just like on my phone, I just swipe up and I can browse and all my apps are there. So it's nice, it's simple, and it's that same type of smartphone experience. And if you're coming over from, let's say, an iPhone.
Yeah, that was my next question. Because
I'm glad you asked. Yeah, okay. So you're coming from an iPhone, right?
Yeah, I'm coming from an iPhone. So what happens to me with this?
It's very simple. Here's the great thing about Google. If you have a Gmail account, and a Gmail account, by the way, is free to create. You have one already?
I have one, yeah.
Well, this is wonderful. Everything syncs with your Gmail account. So when you set up your laptop, it's going to ask you to log into your Gmail. If you don't have one, you just set one up. And then within that email, that's what's going to give you access to syncing everything, which means, and we're going to talk more in depth about this here shortly, if you have applications from Gmail, like Google Docs, like Sheets, things of that nature, you're going to be able to put them on this computer, and then on your smartphone, you'll be able to access that information. So it syncs wirelessly through the cloud. And I'm going to talk about the cloud because I know you're probably concerned about the cloud and a little bit confused about it, right?
The cloud makes me a little crazy and scared. I don't know where it is. I don't know where to get to it. I don't know where my stuff goes when it goes there.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what happens.
Well, you don't have to worry about it because basically all the cloud is, it's like a computer. It's like an internet server that lives somewhere securely, and the information is transferred securely from your computer to the cloud, and then the beautiful thing about the cloud is you can access it anywhere. So let's say, for example, I go over here, and I'm going to open up, let's go to my Google Docs right there. So Docs is kind of a word processing program, right? So I was working on a document before. I'm going to click that open here, and then it's going to open here. And what's going to happen is, there we go, and this is just a standard template. There are tons of templates that you can use, by the way. So this is just one that I went ahead and downloaded, right? So if I were to edit this document here, which I just did, here's what's going to happen. I'm going to grab my smartphone here, and because I know that you're an iPhone person, mm-hmm. I brought my iPhone along too.
Oh, awesome.
So here's what you can do. You can download Google Drive, which you get Google Drive. You get 100 gigabytes of Google Drive for 2 years on your computer, which means you can store 100 gigabytes of information in the cloud for 2 years for no cost. So when I updated this doc, it's automatically in here. So anytime I update a document on my Chromebook, within a matter of seconds, it is updated to my Google Drive on my iPhone or my Android, or I can just log in remotely to any computer in the world and access these files. It's really that simple.
So Alex, are you, just to make it short and sweet, are you saying that it doesn't matter whether I have an Android or an iPhone or any other kind of phone, that it's going to work out very well for us?
Absolutely. So take a look. You've got the document here. I just pulled up the document right here as well. It's the same document. I can edit it on my iPhone, and then it's going to be edited
that's
on my Chromebook.
Awesome.
Isn't that amazing? That's the future we, this is the future that we're currently living in.
Because it used to be that the two can't talk.
Right.
You know?
And let's say, for example, you created a document on your computer, and then you're like, oh, I gotta wait to get home. You know, or unless you have your computer with you, you can't access it. That used to happen to me all the time. But now with the cloud, it's made our life so much easier that you can go ahead and create a document, create notes, take pictures, back up your music files on here, and then you have access to them on your Chromebook. And that's what makes Chromebook so exciting. It's easy, it's powerful, and it syncs, and it just works.
That's awesome. Okay, so that is what Chromebook is all about.
In a nutshell, yeah, it's a little complex. We're going to dive in deep. I want to make sure that you're comfortable with it.
Thank you.
Because I know technology can seem a little overwhelming at times, and especially when you're considering something new.
That's it. I don't want to buy stuff I don't need, Alex.
Right.
But I do want stuff that I am happy to use, and I want to keep up with technology because it gets better and brighter and more fabulous. So I want what I want when I want it. Does that make sense?
It totally makes sense. And I'm glad you said that because that's kind of what you get with Chrome. Chrome uses the web browser Chrome. I'm not sure if you're familiar with that, but you can download it whether you have a Windows computer or a Mac computer. And what I love about Chrome is, like I talked about cloud-based computing before, I can have all of my favorites stored here if I wanted to. And then what I can do is, whether you have a Mac or you have a PC, you can access the Chrome browser, and all of your favorites and everything are stored on there as well.
That's awesome.
If this is a second computer for yourself, if you're using it to travel, which by the way, a lot of people use Chromebooks to travel because they're so lightweight. We're going to talk about the battery life here in a second. And it's such a wonderful computer to have on the go. But if you have, let's say, an all-in-one at home, your Chrome browser will sync all of your favorites, and you never have to worry about, oh, where did I save that bookmark?
Yeah.
Or what are my favorite sites? they all sink due to Chrome.
Geez, so I love this portability that we get with this one, and the price is blowing me away.
It is indeed, right?
Oh, yeah, just forget about the easy pay. Look at the whole price, $399.96, but you can do this on six easy payments of $66.66. You can also do the special financing of 9 months, so that'll make the payments even more affordable. What about the Intel?
Yeah, let's talk about that. And I actually created something that I want to show you here with my Chromebook. It's a program called Slides. And by the way, this is so cool. I want to back up a second and tell you that more and more schools, like elementary schools and high schools, are using Chromebook. Mm-hmm. I was just talking to my nephew, and he was telling me how he uses a program called Google Classroom, where he gets his homework assignments from the teacher. The teacher posts them, and then everyone in the class, it's like a social networking site.
Yeah.
They can comment on that, and then they do their homework on their Chromebook, and he uses this app to create presentations for school.
Oh, that's awesome.
Now, if elementary school students or high school students are using it, you're gonna be able to use
it. You're gonna be able to use
it. And let me just show you how easy it is.
Okay.
So I created a presentation just to show you kind of the specs of the computer so that we can take it step by step by step. So this is the Chromebook. It's a 14-inch screen. That's why I called it the Chromebook 14. I'm gonna hit the present mode, and there we go. So now all of a sudden, I have a presentation. So I'm gonna go right here. This all starts with that Intel Celeron, and now it's a dual core processor. And that's important because you wanna think of a core like a road, right? And let's say, for example, you're driving to work and it's a one lane road and someone gets a flat tire.
Mm.
What's gonna happen? You're gonna get a backlog, right? There's gonna be a traffic jam. But now if another lane opens up, you can just go around that and then the information will continue to flow, or your car will continue, you'll be able to drive your car to another lane. That's what dual core processing is. So you have two cores. So that's why it's important to know that this isn't just a tablet with a keyboard. This is a full-fledged computer that uses the power of the cloud to store and save your documents. And by the way, you know what's great about this?
What?
It's always saving it. So if you create a slideshow like this, you don't have to worry about, you know, if you go away and come back, oh my goodness, did I save it? I powered down the computer. I can't remember whether I saved it. It's automatically saving for you.
Dynamite, automatically. So
automatically.
I don't have to request it. It knows to do it. So it's
exactly.
Pretty smart.
So about every 10 seconds, it'll update to the cloud.
So will you give me a little, oh wait, are we gonna show that battery life first? Or do a little tour of the,
well,
you do what you want to do, Alex.
Yeah,
I like listening.
Awesome. I want to share with you
okay. The
other really exciting stuff, and then we're going to go through the tour because you're going to see you've got so many great ports, and I want to talk. I want to make sure we talk about everything about the Chromebook.
I do too. You take it from here. I love this.
So 11 hours and 30 minutes. That's approximate usage. I actually got more battery life than 11 hours and 30 minutes off of my Chromebook.
Yeah.
So I mean, it'll give you a day, if not 2 days, worth of travel time. So think about it. You know, if you're a person that travels, or you do use it for school or work, you really don't have to worry about having to run out of battery, which is great, right? Mm-hmm. And that's one of the reasons why so many people love Chromebook. I mentioned it before, access to millions of Android apps. There's an app for just about everything, which is great, right? Including the QVC app, which I'll show you here shortly.
Okay.
So it makes it even easier to shop on QVC, right? How about an HP TrueVision HD webcam?
Wow.
So it's right up here, so you can use that if you wanna. You can use Skype on here, because you can download Skype. You can also use something called Google Hangouts. Now, Google Hangouts is just the version of Google's version of Skype, but it's really cool because you can have multiple people on a Hangout. So you can have a party of five on there if you want to. If you want to do a three-way video call, you can do that as well.
Oh my gosh.
You can even chat, which is great. So Google Hangout is great, and you can use it either on your Chromebook or you can download it on your smartphone, whether you have Android or an iPhone, and use the Google Hangout that way.
Nice.
So lots of great stuff,
that's
right?
That's a lot. I mean, I'll be honest with you. When I saw the price, Alex, I didn't think you could do all of that, or because you know you get what you pay for. And I'm looking at the price tag, but then I'm listening to Alex say everything that it can do and everything and how it works. And it sounds like it should cost a lot more. So why doesn't it?
Yeah, well, it doesn't.
What's going on?
So Google has created kind of this whole new niche of computing, right? They came out with Chrome OS, that's the operating system that this works upon. Mm-hmm. And it really started with the Google Docs and the Sheets and everything that comes in terms of the applications where you cloud compute, where you do it on your computer, it goes to the cloud, and then you can access them everywhere. And then they developed basically a computer all around that. And with Android becoming so popular, and there again are millions of apps, now they integrated into that. I always like to say Chromebook is the computer that you're right. It should cost a lot.